SOMED, Cervical Cancer Prevention Awareness and Health Matters. Your partner in health matters. Dedicated to promoting awareness of both male and female issues.
Hello everyone, my name is Edna Dapa and welcome to my channel. Today I will continue the discussion about why women experience abnormal vaginal bleeding, just as I did in my previous video, and continue the awareness creation on this subject. After this delivery, we will begin to realize that some of the causes of abnormal bleeding could be attributed to fundamental processes. The information that will be discussed will empower women to have better understanding on this subject and make better judgment on how to seek professional help when needed. In this video, I will be talking about four processes that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding. They are implantation process, vaginal intercourse during pregnancy, abortion, and ectopic pregnancy. Implantation is the process of attachment and penetration of the endometrium by the released ovum or egg, fertilized or not. Implantation takes place in the uterine wall about 9 days after ovulation. Fertilization of egg by sperm occurs in the fallopian tube, and the fertilized egg moves to the uterus, implanting to the uterine lining. The adherence of fertilized egg to the uterine wall provides a suitable environment for the growth and the development into a new offspring. If an egg is fertilized and implantation is successful, then pregnancy officially begins. Otherwise, the fertilized egg will leave the body probably during period or as miscarriage. Meanwhile, unfertilized eggs leave the body through menstruation. In some women, as the embryo implants itself to the lining of the uterus, it causes a light abnormal bleeding from the vagina. This is known as implantation bleeding, which is pinkish or brownish in color. Another process that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding is vaginal intercourse during pregnancy. Many couples continue their sexual encounters during pregnancy without any substantial difficulties, although some females may experience displeasure or discomfort. If pregnancy is normal and without complications, it is perfectly safe to have sex unless the doctor or midwife has advised against it. A little spotting after sex due to changes to the cervix during pregnancy is almost normal. Before conception, the cervix is quite firm, like an unripe fruit, and it becomes incredibly soft during pregnancy. The function of the cervix from the moment of conception is the maintenance of the pregnancy and protection of the growing fetus. Throughout pregnancy, the cervix remains closed despite multiple forces acting upon it. An initial mucus plug of the cervix is an effective barrier that could deter influx of microorganisms from the vagina. During pregnancy, hormonal changes cause the cervix to become more vascular, softer, and an increase in blood volume. This makes it extremely sensitive, and if it is bumped during penetrative sexual intercourse, it could bleed, and such bleeding will be expressed as postcoital bleeding. If spotting persists or the bleeding is heavy with clots or bright red, it is wise to consult a medical professional. Another process that could cause a woman to experience abnormal vaginal bleeding is abortion. Abortion is a procedure to end a pregnancy using medicine or surgery to remove an embryo or fetus and placenta from the uterus. Abortion occurs by intervention or without intervention. Spontaneous abortions or miscarriage is abortion without intervention and occurs in about 30 to 40% of pregnancies. When deliberate steps are taken to end a pregnancy, it is called an induced abortion. Abortion is also described as ending a pregnancy early without the natural birth of the child. It is sometimes called termination of pregnancy. It is also a procedure applied in cases of impending miscarriages. Bleeding is a side effect of both medication and surgical abortion, and in most cases, the provider will advise about the bleeding. However, abnormal vaginal bleeding could be experienced in the process. Ending a pregnancy is a common decision that millions of people make, as about a quarter of pregnancies end in abortion every year, regardless of whether abortion is legal or not. Another process that could cause abnormal vaginal bleeding is ectopic pregnancy. During normal pregnancy, the fetus implants in the lining of the uterus for development. An ectopic pregnancy occurs when a fertilized egg implants and grows outside the main cavity of the uterus. Ectopic pregnancy could occur in the ovary, cervix, and most often in the fallopian tube, where it is referred to as tubal pregnancy. Meanwhile, a fertilized egg can only grow properly in the uterus. An ectopic pregnancy cannot proceed normally, and the fertilized egg cannot survive, whilst the entire process could cause life-threatening condition if left untreated. Some women with ectopic pregnancy do not have any symptoms at first, whilst others with ectopic pregnancy could experience abnormal vaginal bleeding that may be mistaken for a regular period. Another symptoms may include light to heavy vaginal spotting or bleeding that may be watery and dark brown in color. Ectopic pregnancy is not safe for the mother, and the embryo will not be able to develop to term. It is necessary to eliminate the embryo as soon as possible for the mother's immediate health and long-term fertility. It is also not possible to save the pregnancy, because if the fertilized egg continues to grow in the fallopian tube, it could cause the tube to rupture. This will create a medical emergency and will be life-threatening to the woman. It's advisable to see a medical practitioner immediately if ectopic pregnancy is suspected. Natural and fundamental processes are sometimes the driving forces of abnormal vaginal bleeding, as in the case of implantation bleeding discussed in this video. Vaginal bleeding may sometimes not warrant any cause for alarm, but it is always worth checking with a medical professional, as such bleeding could be indicative of a medical concern, as with ectopic pregnancy. I invite you to partner with me on Healthcare Matters for Everyone. Our partnership will be in the form of you disseminating this information to get to as many people as possible to achieve our goal of saving lives. Please join me next time when I will be talking about more causes of abnormal vaginal bleeding. Thanks for watching, and please like and share this video to your friends and family, and I will see you soon.